Cloth is something that I take for granted every day. But you know who probably didn't take their cloth for granted? Neolithic people in Mesopotamia. I'm about to spin like it's 6099 BCE. I look around me right now and I see towels, rugs, upholstery on the furniture, throw blankets, curtains, clothing. And it really amazes me because really not even that many generations ago, a blink in the span of humanity, everything that all people interacted with was hand-spun. It was completely hand-spun and hand-woven. Before the Industrial Revolution happened about 200 years ago, literally every single strand, every single thread was spun by hand. Just imagine the yards and yards of fabric and all of the time that went into creating enough yardage for, you know, say a Renaissance dress with all the poofs. All those poofs, that's a lot of work. I mean, is there anything more opulent than pleats when you're working with hand-spun, hand-woven fabric? Okay, let's forget fashion for a moment and just consider the amount of work it would take to hand spin and weave enough material to outfit your ship with sails, because sails were hand woven and hand spun as well. Wow, that's mind boggling to me. I have been reading and learning so much about history and especially spinning, because as we know, I'm Evie and I spin yarn. And I find it just endlessly fascinating. There is so much to learn about how people of different times and cultures have spun and made cloth. I have so many inspired projects coming up, so make sure that you are subscribed if you are not subscribed yet. What are you waiting for? But seriously, you won't want to miss what's coming. Lately, I've really had a lot of fun looking at spindle whorls. That's the round disc that goes around the shaft of a spindle for spinning yarn. Spindle whorls are ubiquitous objects that are found everywhere in archaeological sites that span time, geography, cultures. As soon as civilization began, it began with spinning. Spindle whorls that are made of stone, bone, ceramic, and various materials like that have been able to survive the passage of time, but the thing that hasn't survived is the cloth itself. In most cases, we just don't have any record of what the actual cloth was that people were creating or what their fashions were. In a few cases, we might have some isolated artwork on pottery or frescoes or things like that, but as a whole, for the most ancient of peoples, we really don't know. We also don't know what their exact methods of spinning were. We just don't know. We have great educated guesswork, but ultimately it really truly is still just guesswork. So until someone invents a time machine, we just don't know. But we do have those ubiquitous spindle whorls. And so we can replicate those and do a little experimenting to see, working with physics and different types of wool or flax, etc., we can kind of make some educated guesses ourselves as to how people may have spun in the past. Last month, I purchased two Neolithic form spindle whorls from the Dancing Goats on Etsy. They have amazing craftsmanship, wonderful, wonderful things on their Etsy site. So I will put a link in the description below so you can go check them out if you would like to. I purchased these. These are the whorls that I got. Aren't they just beautiful? The shape and weight of these is a replication of spindle whorls that were found in an archaeological dig in Mesopotamia, and these would date back to about 9,000 years ago. So this is at the dawn of civilization as we recognize it, with farming and using a furnace to fire clay and create pottery, and that's what these were made of, pottery. And I also got some spindle shafts. These are oak, and I've been playing around with these. A couple of these do have metal hooks on them, so of course that wouldn't be quite so old, because Neolithic would come before Bronze Age, where we would possibly start to see metal in use like that. But we do have some of these shafts that we can use in a supported spinning style. So I want to show you what style I have sort of settled into that works really well with these spindle whorls. And this is just my take on it, just from my experience with how it's working with the materials that I have. Yeah, but I'm really excited to show you. So let's get spinning. These are the two spindle whorls that I got. This one is pretty cool. It has some purple. We all know I love purple, and some blue in the glaze. On the other side, it just has some speckles. Then the other one I have has some little line burst, kind of a sunburst design around it, around the edge of it. And it's the same color on both sides. It's very interesting because this one, because it's a little further spread out, this one seems to spin longer. This one seems to spin quicker but shorter, if that makes sense. So I think one of the really interesting things is the idea that you can change the whorl off of your spindle shaft as you fill that spindle with your wool. As you spin, the wool is going to add weight and change how the spin feels, and you can adjust your whorl accordingly throughout the course of your project. And I think that is a really cool feature of this style of spindle, where you can take the whorls off and on. This is the material that I will be spinning today. It is a blend, an interesting blend of alpaca, merino, and mohair. I don't think that this would probably be authentically accurate to that time period way back in Mesopotamia, but it's what I have to work with. And I kind of like the feeling of it in that it's not a perfectly blended fine merino, for example. There's something about this that just feels a little more rustic, if we want to use that word as a description. So it's working well. This is what I have done so far. This is the yarn that I have built up in my cob here. And I put a spindle whorl on here. So I started with the larger one. And so I will continue with the larger one. The way to get this on the shaft so that it doesn't just fall off while you're spinning, it does occasionally, but for the most part, slide it up until it can't slide up anymore, and then just give it a slight twist. And that seems to give it enough friction that it takes a little wiggle and a tug to get it back off again. Over time, it starts to wear down the shaft, but in terms of material, it seems to make a little more sense to have the specific whorls that I like with a lot of spindle sticks than to constantly be changing whorls and keep the same spindle sticks. I don't know, these are just some observations. My goal while I spin this is to be able to have as much twist going into the fibers without interruption as possible. So right now, the twist is interrupted. I've stopped it from twisting while I set up my drafting zone, and this is inefficient right at this moment. So what I wanna try and do is be able to have it twist while I'm drafting, and that makes it more efficient. This is called semi-continuous supported spindle spinning, if we use our technical modern terms for this. Here's what it looks like while I'm drafting. Here we go. Had some thin spots there. This is definitely a different feel. Oh no, it came apart. I had a thin spot. That happens. This is a challenge, but I'm enjoying this challenge. Here's what this fiber looks like if I take it and just kind of show the staple length. So it's not very, very long, but it is a little wiry. There we go. I'm not sure if I should be blaming all those guard hairs on the alpaca or if that is a bonus feature from the mohair that's in here. It could be either. So once I get down to just a little bit in my hand, just this little amount, then I break off another piece and put it together so that I don't have to really worry about a specific join. And that's been helping. So here we go. Is this the method that these ancient people were using to create the trendiest of fashionable fashions of their time? I really don't know. I don't think that there's truly a way that we can know. I can say that when I'm spinning and using tools similar to what those people may have used, I feel a connection somehow. A connection through, oh, dare I say it, a thread. Through just the generations of civilization and culture and humanity. There's something about that thread that I feel connects me, and I like that. And it certainly reminds me not to take any of the cloth or fabric around me for granted. Let me know in the comments down below what you think of this style of spinning. Have you tried spinning with a spindle whorl like this? If you have, what did you think of it? I'm really curious to know and hear from some fellow spinners, some fellow fiber friends. All right, make sure you give a thumbs up if you love spinning and you enjoyed this video. I will see you in the next one. Happy spinning. I'm going to spin like it's 6099 BCE. Oh.